It's Thursday, December 12th, 2013. I'm Ross Miller, record holder for the highest snood score in the greater Atlanta area. This is 90 Seconds on the Verge. One day after Twitter added private pictures to direct messaging, Instagram has announced its own messaging feature called Instagram Direct. The new feature, which is available starting today for iOS and Android, allows users to privately send text, video, and photo messaging to up to 15 friends. And just like Twitter, only the people you follow can send you photos and video, so there goes any chance of a Justin Timberlake bromance. In the future, cars will talk to each other and nearly drive themselves. That's at least what Ford is trying to prove. The automaker today unveiled the Ford Fusion Hybrid automated research vehicle, which, as the name suggests, is a modified Fusion that's able to drive on its own by detecting the world around it. Ford now joins a number of automakers with an interest in self-driving cars. Ford says most of the automation will not be deployed until 2025, but it will try to phase in things little by little before then. You know, things like AI road rage. Finally, Fast and Furious will return, and Paul Walker will get the send-off he deserves. Sources familiar with the matter say that screenwriter Chris Morgan has begun revising the script for Fast and Furious 7 to allow for Walker's character to exit the series using footage that has already been shot. Walker had already shot about half the scenes prior to his sudden death last month. Fast 7 was scheduled to hit theaters in July 2014, but this timetable has now been scrapped. The hope is now that with a reworked script, the cast and crew can get back to filming in January, but that's far from a guarantee. That's it for today's top stories, but coming up tomorrow, we take a look at the Golden Globe's newest category, Best News Show Under 2 Minutes, that does pop culture references and makes really weird jokes and/or does a musical.